Ever tried combining Excel sheets in Power BI, only to realize each sheet needs its own cleanup first? Let me show you how you can clean and combine every sheet automatically without having to hard code every step. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. So here are the Excel sheets that we're trying to combine, budget 23, 24, 25. And as you can see here, that this is, you know, not machine friendly data. And what that means is this is going to require transformation before we load these sheets into Power BI. So let's see how we can do that. Now we had a previous video where we showed you how to get data from all sheets in Excel, but we had a comment from a viewer saying that, hey, how can we do that with additional transformation? So we're going to pick up from there, and thank you for your comments and your questions. So we have the simple scenario we had covered in the previous video where you can see this is clean data. This does not require any transformation. And this I actually already have loaded in my file here, budget simple sheets, using the steps in the previous video. Go back and watch that video. We're going to link it in the corner and in the description below. But let's see how we can do that with this slightly messier data. Again, it's not like messy from human sense, but from a machine perspective is not ideal. So we're going to see how we can transform it. I'm going to close this file. I'm going to go back here. I'm going to say new source Excel workbook and point to my budget file. By the way, if you're looking to download our files, just go to learnpowerbi.com/download and you will get access to our best free resources and these files that you can follow along with in these videos. All right, so we have this navigation bar open when after connecting the Excel file, it's showing us all the sheets. And really, it doesn't matter at this point which sheet you select. I'm going to select budget 2023, hit OK. And from here, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to delete these steps, which are getting the data from the sheet. Because again, we don't want the single sheet. We want all the budget sheets from here. So I'm going to remove the navigation step as well and just leave it like this. And I'm going to rename this to budget source. I'm going to right click on this and uncheck the enable load. This is a source query. I really don't want to load it to my data model. Now the steps we're going to follow roughly similar to what we showed you how the Power BI get data from folder works. So we have a separate video for that. And if we look at that, when you get data from folder, what we covered in this video is we showed you how these internal structures work, specifically these paired query and function, right? So if you've used get data from folder, and especially if you've watched that video, you're familiar with how these work. These are paired. We're going to use something similar to that. Okay, so let's continue with our budget source. I'm going to right click and reference, and I'm just going to select the first one. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go back, and this one, I have both the simple and the advanced sheets. The simple one are already in this query, so I'm going to exclude them from here. So I'm going to say name starts with budget. And remember, Power Query is case sensitive, so the B needs to be capital. This is better. And now we have budget, and I'm going to change this to get budget query. All right. And we're going to have a mirror function, just like we have it in the, get data from folder. We're going to create a matching query and a matching function. And don't worry if that's not making sense. I'm going to walk you through it step by step. So we have the get budget query. And what I really need is just the first row and its data table. And by the way, you can click, don't click on the word table. If you click next to it, you can see what's inside. Power BI shows you a preview. So I want to work on that. And essentially what I'm going to do is I'm going to teach this query on how to query a single sheet. Then I'm going to turn this into a function, a Power Query function. And then that function can be called on the budget source. Again, we're going to walk through it together step by step. So to get the first row and the table, what I'm going to do here is budget source. and I'm going to use curly brackets, 0, and that's going to give me the first row. So that gives me this first row, budget 2023, but really I'm only interested in the data table, the data column. So I'm going to use square brackets and write a data, and that's going to give me that column. Now what Power BI does is it adds this additional step automatically. Frankly, I'm never a fan of change type, the automatic change type step. I recommend you always delete it. I think I have a video on that one as well on why that's important. Okay, so we deleted that step, and we actually don't need this promoted headers as well. So I'm going to delete this step, and now this is the start of my query, which is also going to be the start of my function. We're going to pass in a data table, which is essentially an Excel sheet. Now let's teach this query how to work with this data. So we can see there are some header rows here. So 1, 2, 3 header rows. So we're going to remove those. Remove top rows, 3 rows, hit OK, that's done. Use first row as headers. Headers are promoted. There are these subtotals and grand totals here. I don't need that, that's redundant. So I'm gonna say text filter does not contain the word, maybe say, let's say total, and again, T capital, this is case sensitive. And now I'm gonna select these columns and I'm gonna just unpivot the other columns. So unpivot other columns, and everything is looking good. I'm going to change this attribute. I'm just going to make this change in the M query itself. So I'm going to call this month, and this we're going to call the budget amount. Now there's a small mistake here, but I'm intentionally leaving it there. So if you're noticing that, don't worry, we'll come back and fix it. Now this is our function. Now we're not going to load this function. So I'm going to right click and uncheck the enable load. So again, if you go back to the example of get files from a folder, Power Query creates these paired functions. And these are pretty amazing because they mirror each other. Well, actually the function mirrors the query, and it doesn't let you edit this by default, or it does let you edit, but it gives you a warning. And whatever changes you make in the query are automatically reflected in the function. We don't quite have that functionality here, but what we're gonna do is we're just gonna duplicate this one and turn this into a function. So I'm gonna rename this to function. And to do that, we're gonna click Advanced Editor, and we're just gonna insert something here. So by the way, you can just do brackets and then space equal and the greater than sign, and that converts it to a function. I'm just going to click done, and notice that it is now a function. That's all you have to do. But of course we need one slight change in here, which is we need to pass in a parameter. So for that, go back to the brackets and you can just type in the parameter or parameters if you have multiple parameters. And we're going to say this is a budget data table. I sometimes prefix variables with V. So we'll say V budget data. And you can define the type, but leaving it leaves it as any, which that means it can be any data type. But you know, that works for us. So V budget data. So this is good. Now it's taking a parameter. So you're going to notice that this one changes here. Now it's accepting a parameter here. But we need to hook in the parameter. We need to actually use the parameter. So what we're going to do is we're going to change this source column. And right now it's hard coded to reading that budget, the first row, essentially budget 2023. So instead of that, we're going to comment this out. And we're going to simply plug in budget data. So we're going to say, yep, just use the budget data table that's being passed into you. Now that becomes our function. Now all we have to do is go back to the budget source and invoke this function. Use this function for all these sheets. But what we're going to do is we're going to right click and say reference. And I'm going to call this budget. I think this is going to be our final table. And we don't need all these columns. We're just going to keep name and data. So I'll say remove other columns. And now I'm going to say add column. Invoke custom function, that's right there. So click on that and we can select the function, get budget function, and new column name is good. And we're passing in the data column here for the V budget data variable. We're passing in this data table and hit OK. Now, again, I had mentioned that I'm going to leave an error in there, but if you look at this, at least the first table works here. So the first table works, but if you click on the second one, we can see that there's a problem here, and there seems to be some hard coding that we left in there. So for that, we can go back to our query and try to fix it. Now, if I step through these steps, I realize that there was an automatically added change type step, and that's the reason I do not like these, because they end up hard coding a lot of things in your query. So this is the one that's hard coded, and it's referencing Jan 2023. I don't really need this because these columns are going to be unpivoted anyway. So I'm going to delete this change type step. So that's gone. So there's no reference to Jan 2023. And while I'm here, I'm also going to remove this grand total. This is not needed either. So I'm going to say remove this column. And now I think we should be good to go. But unlike the scenario where you're getting files from a folder where if you make a change to the query, it's automatically reflected in the function. That's not going to happen for us. So we just need to manually mirror the changes from one to the other, but that's easy enough. We'll take this query, go to the home tab, click on the advanced editor, and I'm just going to copy the whole thing, cancel out of this, and go back to the function advanced editor, and I'm going to insert it after this source column. So I'm going to delete everything here. And of course, you can see that there are some redundant steps in here. So we don't really need this, and this we had already switched to this one. So I'm just going to delete that part and make sure there are no errors at the bottom, and this should be good. And now our query is going to reflect that. So if you go back to budget, now we can see that those errors are gone. This table is coming in cleanly. The 2024 table is coming in cleanly. So is 2025. So let's move on to the rest of the steps. We don't really need this data column anymore. So let's remove that. And now we can go to this table and expand it. So I'm just going to click on the icon next to it and select all the columns and hit OK. And now all you have to do is just make sure to change the type for selected columns. So I'm going to make this whole number. You really only need to care about numeric and date time columns, so that those are the only ones we're going to change. And hit close and apply. So that's it. Our data is loaded in and it's coming from all these Excel sheets which require transformation. If you're stuck anywhere else with Power BI, just leave a comment below, or even better, contact me on LinkedIn. Make sure to follow me on YouTube, of course, or you can also email us at avi@avisingh.com. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and power on.